And we're back. And this week, I found the Jessica Jones book I've finally been looking for. Fell in love with the first issue. And also, I read a book about a Bruce Wayne-ish child, but add skeletons and also murder time. Without further ado, let's talk comics. Now, you may know how this show works, but here's the skinny. I'm going to talk about the comics I picked up last week, so if you missed them, you can pick them up this week. I'm going to talk about the comics that I'm picking up this week that we're going to talk about next week if you'd like to read them with me. And then we have Nerd News in 60 Seconds, which is going to be all about Wizard World, which is coming here to Portland. So we're going to start with Jessica Jones' Blind Spot. I finally found it. It's the Jessica Jones book I have been jonesing for. I'm not sorry for that joke. I knew I could put all my faith in Kelly Thompson. I love her. I think she's a fantastic writer. And you may have already read this comic because it was a Marvel Digital exclusive, but I have not. And I really, really liked this first issue. In fact, I'm going to keep reading it, which is a lot because I read first issues for the show. And then I get tired and I don't want to read other stuff. I enjoyed this first issue. I enjoyed this first issue for a lot of reasons, but mostly because you got a look into who Jessica Jones is, and I really like her because she's a deeply flawed character. You get to see her kind of, or you learn about her backstory as a caped crusader, and she wasn't very good at it. So she stopped and she became a PI, and in this storyline, she's married to Luke Cage, they have a daughter, things seem to be going well, but she also knows not to take that for granted because her life is full of hiccups. And I really like that about Jessica Jones. She's smart, she's sassy, she's a hard worker, and she goes into work after spending the lovely day with her family, very domestic, very cute in the beginning of this comic, only to find somebody murdered inside of her office, as one does. But she knows this woman. This woman's name is Sloane. She worked on Sloane's case, where she found out that Sloane's boyfriend was cheating on her, even though Sloane already knew. But Sloane wanted Jessica Jones to find proof, so maybe she would have the strength to leave her abusive boyfriend. Now, it stands to reason that perhaps the abusive boyfriend killed Sloane, but why would he kill her in Jessica Jones's office? And weirder than that is that as soon as Jessica Jones touched the body to see if she was indeed dead, there were cops that were flocking. Seems like a setup to me. And they hold her in jail for a long time when we get a nice cameo by Matt Murdock, her lawyer, and also Daredevil, who breaks her free. And now Jessica Jones has to figure out why Sloane was found dead in her office. Oh, but this comic ends on a cliffhanger because Jessica Jones goes back to her office to look through her files and stuff, and then she gets murdered. The end of this comic is that she is murdered in her office. Ah! Oh my God, pick up the second one. Find out how she gets unmurdered, because obviously she gets unmurdered. Like what? So anyway, this comic is really good. If you haven't read it, again, it was a Marvel Digital exclusive, so you may have read it before, but if you haven't read it, I definitely recommend that you pick it up at the shop and go. And the second comic I picked up last week was actually a second issue, which we don't normally do for the show, but listen, I really wanted to read this. I slept on the first issue, because I'm dumb, and I'm sorry, I hope you forgive me, because it was actually really good. It fulfilled a lot of things I mentioned that I liked last week about the synopsis that I had read about this. It has a morally gray vigilante superhero murderer, some true crime-ish aspects of it as well. In the first issue, you meet Skeleton Boy in quite a dramatic fashion. His parents are murdered by somebody, small-time criminal, and Skulldigger jumps on the scene and murders the criminal. He tells Skeleton Boy, look away, like you don't want to see this, and Skeleton Boy makes dead eye contact with him while he just like murders a guy. It's a lot. And then Skeleton Boy gets taken into protective custody, but Skulldigger can't stop thinking about him because all the guts, I guess, it took to watch a murder. I don't know, it's all very strange. Anyway, Skulldigger goes, he collects the boy, and they now have this Batman and Robin-ish sort of relationship, but a little more abusive, you know? Skulldigger locks him in a room for a long time, makes him fight kind of brutally. It's a whole thing. And all the while, there is a detective on Skulldigger's tail, or at least she wants to be. Detective Reyes wants to arrest Skulldigger for murdering the murderer of Skeleton Boy's parents. But the police chief says, no, we can't bring in Skulldigger, he's killing bad people. But Reyes isn't the only person who wants to see Skulldigger gone. There's somebody running for mayor, his name is Tex Reed, and he used to be a caped crusader back in the day because in Spiral City, the superheroes aren't unknown to them. So he's running for mayor, he's running on this platform, and he's saying, back in my day, superheroes used to be great, but now we just have these bad vigilantes, and I want to see Skulldigger brought to justice. So people don't really like Skulldigger, even though he seems to be killing bad people. That's a whole moral argument I don't want to get into. But on the last page of the second issue, the bad guy who's just broken out of jail, because that's what bad guys do, named Grim Jim, he's purple, skeleton-y, he tranquilizes the mayor candidate, maybe kills, looks like tranquilizes though, and he makes a narcissistic statement, as narcissistic bad guys do, and it looks like it's all going to hell, so I'm excited. It was well written. You are sort of torn about Skulldigger. Do you like him? Is he sensitive? Is he mean? Like, I don't know. And also, you're really interested in Skeleton Boy, because not only is he going through all these terrible and traumatic PTSD life changes, but also you get a glimpse into his dialogue kind of from the future. He thought that Skulldigger was bringing him up and taking him under his wing, but it turns out that the first person that Skeleton Boy will kill is Skulldigger. It's according to his conjecture. So I'm really interested to see how that dynamic builds and maybe falls apart. I really like these morally gray characters. I love to see writers sort of flex that muscle where they walk the line. And I think Jess Lemire is gonna do a great job. So if you haven't picked up this comic, if you slept on it like I did, don't, it is good. What are you reading? What did you pick up last week? Are you reading anything fun? Should I be reading it? Please let me know in the comment section below. Or you can, that was a rhyme. Or you can hit me up on Twitter. Where I basically just post pictures of my dog and, like, Baby Yoda. Anyway, there you go. And this week I'm picking up comics from the big two, that is Marvel and DC. Usually I try and pick up something a little different, but listen, they got some stuff coming out that I'm interested in. And the first of which is Wonder Woman number 750, which is going to be a 96-page celebration of Diana Prince, which I'm very here for, and I'm really interested because a lot of writers who have written her before, including some writers I'm a big fan of, like Gail Simone and Greg Rucka, will be writing stories that are in this 96-page extravaganza. So I think it's really cool. I think it's one of those collector's issues that you're gonna wanna pick up if you're interested in Wonder Woman at all, and I am. So I'm excited to read that. The little synopsis on Previews World said that there's gonna be like short stories about her past and her future, and I think that's all very cool. So, and I like to pick up things like this, I guess it's like part of collecting things. I don't know. I'm excited. And the second comic that I'm picking up is Ruins of Ravencroft, Dracula number one, which sounds really dramatic, but it has Captain America fighting Dracula and like, what in the weird crossover? I'm very interested in that. Steve Rogers, our lawful good father. I don't know if he wanted to be my dad or my child or my boyfriend. It's weird. I'm gonna cut that out. Anyway, I'm very here to see Steve Rogers, our lawful good patriot fighting Dracula, because like it's just so weird to me. And so the idea is that Ravencroft is this like place for the criminally insane, but Captain America is gonna find out some stuff. Did I mention he's gonna fight Dracula? So weird, so weird, but I can't wait. So that's what I'm picking up next week. Yeah, I'm excited. I don't really know much about the ruins of Ravencroft, although I've seen some talk about it on the interweb. We'll see what it's about. And here's your nerd news in 60 seconds. Wizard World is coming to Portland. It begins this Friday, January 24th, and goes through this Sunday, January 26th. And as you're going to get your nerd on, seeing actors from your favorite shows, like The Walking Dead, Smallville, voice actors from X-Men the Animated Series, which is a personal favorite of mine, be sure that you bring all your old books and graphic novels that you're no longer using or you don't want to collect, because you can donate them to Portland Books to Prisoners, which is a not-for-profit that offers books to those who are incarcerated. There will be a designated donation spot near the special guest registration desk where you can drop off your books. And if you bring more than two, then you get a signed copy of a picture of somebody who was at Wizard World last year, which is very cool, while supplies last. And I'm gonna be there live with Tonight with Cassidy on Friday, so if you see us, say hi. I will also be there on Saturday covering all the cool and exciting things, so drop me a line if you're gonna be there here on Twitter. This has been your Nerd News in 60 seconds. Oh, and it's week two of forgetting to shoot myself an outro for my video. I'm so disappointed in myself. But I'm in the car on the way to my local comic book shop, Floating World Comics, located at 400 Northwest Cooch Street, because it's Wednesday! It's new comic book day, I'm so excited.
It is Wednesday, my dudes.
Let me know what you're reading, what you're enjoying. And I'll see you guys next week, same-ish time, same place. And until then, this has been KGW's Comic Pick of the Week.